Well, guys, welcome to another weekly briefing here. Today for you guys, I'm going to be doing a review on 7-star Trident, also known as Neptunian Trident. So he was one of the first soul blossom units that got a 7-star treatment, along with Ultor, who is also now a 7-star. So yeah, so Trident is definitely the best defensive unit in the game by far. Before he said this 7-star game, Trident was the best 7-stars on global right now. Yeah. On global back then, so yeah. So, let's start off with the stats first. So, Trident has a fairly high HP due to his spear. Being able to increase his overall HP by 40% when you equip Trident's Trident. Basically, his spear boosts his HP by 40%, and his extra skill boosts HP by 40% as well, so you get a total 80% boost HP. So you can see Trident here has 15,000 HP max. On max, so yeah, if you max the Trident, you will get if you max the Trident's HP, his HP will go up to about 15,000 for lower types. It can go up to 17 or 16k for random types. So yeah, it depends on your spear build. So the stats, Trident has pretty awesome stats. Yeah, it's high HP. Fairly decent attack, high defense, and he has extremely high recovery since his leader skill boosts all units and his own recovery by 50%. So that's the highest so far in the game. Alright, and let's talk about the types now. So the best type of Trident would be Animal, because Animal would have the highest HP. Breaker, if you want to do decent damage using Trident, then it's probably best for you to use a breaker type. And if you want to balance between if you want Trident to be balanced, then go for a blue red. Yeah. Oracle is probably not the best type, because it just boosts his HP, and that's pretty much it. Before the before they change the Oracle type, it's used to be increase wreck recovery, but Oracle has the lowest HP among all the other types before the update. Yeah. So for Trident, you would be better off to use Lord or Animal type of him. Yeah. Alright, so let's go on to his abilities. Let's start with the leader skill. Lord of the Blue Abyss. 40% boost HP wreck, boosts speed of each turn with Trident. So that's interesting. Lord of the Blue Abyss, 40% boost to max HP, 50% boost to max wreck, 10% damage reduction, and 20% boost to critical hit rate. So basically, his leader skill boosts the overall HP of units by 40%, increase recovery by 50%, increases critical hit rate by 20%, and mitigates damage for all elements by 10%. And the great thing about Cerulean is he gives the highest maximum HP, which is 40%. Your units will have higher chance of recovering HP, and he gives 10% critical hit rate, So if you're using a crit damage unit that does crit damage on either big SPV or leader skill, they will have a higher chance of, or probably just a slight chance of, always landing crit on the enemy. But yeah, still a good proper though. And the best part of Zero Skill is he can mitigate all damage by 10%. So which is why he is the King of Trials, because he can reduce all the enemy damage by 10%. And 10% is really high. So if you're fighting against Master Zabal or even Ark, if they do their ultimate attacks, it will be reduced by half with his leader skill. And stacks with your mitigators SBB as well, and UBB. So it's a good thing. Alright. So basically, Trident has one of the best skills in the game by far. The second best skill in the game would be Deimos. So he gives the same HP boost 40%. And, in the status elements and boost ability attack. That's a really cool and OP leader skill, in my opinion. Alright, so let's Trident's just a freaking beast in Trunks. Alright, let's move to this BB, SBB, and UBB. So it's BB, Torrential Sanctuary, 40 copper water attack on all foes, cast shield for 2 turns, and gradually recovers HP for 3 turns. What that basically does is he casts Earth Shield for 2 turns. And he heals HP for 3 turns. So Trident has become a healer on 7 stars. 7 star form. Yeah. Before he only used to do the Earth Shield on his BB. Both his BB and his BB. But now his 7 stars has actually improved. Yeah, so they gave Trident's BB, they gave healing of return effect on Trident's BB, which is really good. So with Trident in the squad, you don't have to bring a healer and healers, because he can recover HP for 3 turns. It's almost like Kalina's edge skill in her sphere, Xira, which he was HP every turn. Yeah. Well, as long as you can use his BB, then that would be cool, I guess. But but normally you just use his SBB for the extra 40% boost defense, which is a lot better than his BB, and it boosts AC drop as well. Well, if you're gonna use Trident, then I suggest you have to bring either Kranz or Lima for the extra heal. In case Trident falls short on his BB. So, yeah. And the Earth Shield is a pretty tough shield. He's the only one that can cast Earth Shield on all allies. That's why he's pretty special. It's a pretty unique 7 star. Just like the SBS 7 stars, they have their own abilities, own special abilities. So the other that the Japan 7 stars doesn't have. Which makes them really beast. Alright. So let's move on to this SBB, Cerulean Bastille. Getting combo water attack on all foes, cast shield for 2 turns. Boost BC HE drop rate for 3 turns. So basically it's SBB, it's the same SBB but with an extra 140% boosted defense. And the healing overturn effect has been replaced by BCHC drop rate effect. So Tridon has become a BCHC buffer as well. So you can use him in replace Fever or any BCHC droppers. Well, actually, Fever is still the best BCHC dropper in the game by far. She gives the highest BCHC drop rate. Fill rate. Yeah. But Tridon is a lot better because it has two extra buffs, which boosts defense to 140%. And cast Earth Shield. The Earth Shield on its SBB is a lot tougher now because it gives an extra 3,500 defense on his Earth Shield. Yeah. So your units will basically get a total of 140% defense plus the 3,500 defense from his Earth Shield. And if you're using Mitigator, they get an extra 750% reduction damage. And then actually stacks, which runs SPP, which is good. And also if you're using a defense buffer, like Melchior or Aurelion, it's gonna decrease the damage even more. Which is really awesome. That's what I like about Tridon, his SPP stacks with defense buffers and Mitigators. Alright, let's go to this UBB now. Oceanic Grandiose. 18 combo water attack on all foes. Cast shield for 3 turns. Boost BB gauge. Fill rate. Which is this, that's 3 turns as well. 3 turns and probable attack defense reduction. So basically, he's UBB. Gives a total of 20,000 HP Earth Shield. Reduces a chance to reduce enemy's attack and defense. And boost BB gauge with it. This is the reason why Tridon is the best defensive unit in the game. It's because he gives 20,000 HP Earth Shield. That Earth Shield, that 20,000 HP Earth Shield is a lifesaver. It can save you from ultimate attacks and trials. I've proven to you guys that you can survive the boss and the spooky set. It works. It works. Since the Volvo does more than 20k damage, his UBB will has a chance of reducing it as well. So that's the great thing about UBB. He gives 100,000 HP Earth Shield and reduces attack defense stat. So if you manage to do that, attack down on his UBB, the damage will be decreased. And against his 20,000 HP shield, that damage will just deal about 5-10% of the overall damage output. Yeah. It's basically a mitigator. He's a mitigator. It's on serious skill. And also on CV, but he's not completely together because he just boosts defense and his mitigation is quite low on the meter scale, but it's still good, it's still good. CBB is just it's just a one-of-a-kind UBB, it's the best UBB on global by far. Well, before the 07 Star came out, it was the best, but now Zelda has the best UBB because of its massive, insane damage output of its UBB, yeah. And yeah, he boosted the bigger shooter as well, so I'm pretty sure it's about 30% or 40%. Yeah. I will give this DVB a score of 10 out of 10 since it's the best DVB. One of the best. Yeah, there's no denying it. Try this DVB. It's even better than Elimo's UBB, Kran's UBB, and it's 100 times better than a mitigator CBB. Alright, so let's move to his extra skill now. So his extra skill is Soul of the Leviathan. 40% boost HP, Wreck, and boost big H each turn with Trident. Trident is equipped. So basically, you get an extra 40% boost to HP. So basically, Trident gets a total boost of 40% boost to HP and 50% boost to Wreck. And BB Regen for each turn when you equip his favorite Trident. It's actually a good leader skill, extra skill, because Trident can survive better with that extra skill, and he can easily use BB and SBB, BB BH spirit on effects on his extra skill. So yeah. So overall, would give Tridon a rating of 9.4 out of 10. He is not the best unit in the game, because Zedus has already taken control from him. But he is still one of the best units on global. Probably the best soul bouncer of the unit. I'm not saying he is better than Zedus, but in terms of versatility, Tridon. Tridon is better, yeah. Alright. For trials, he is the best unit to use as a leader. GGC is everything, he's the best. Except for Arena, he's not really good to use in Arena, since some of the players there use attack boosting bits like Quaid, Kranz, Michelle, Hadron, Ultor. Yeah. So yeah. Overall, it's a pretty awesome unit. So I'm gonna show you Tridon's BB SBB animation. Trial X2 against Estia. And also, I'm going to show you that I'm going to use Strat CDB to so that we can survive Xenonis's massive AoE attacks on the last forms. So let's go do some research now. And for this trial, we're going to use Tridon's lead, since he's the one that I'm reviewing in this video, and we're going to go with Deimos' friend. Using demos is so we can fill our big gauge when SS first form, when we fight against SS first form. So since we're using demos, I say that we should be good with that squad setup. Yeah, I'm gonna replace Arc Senya. Since we already have Deimos. Let's go on. It's just gonna override our attack buff. So let's just use Deimos attack buff. And let's bring Zenya in for the more damage. She boosts BB attack and spark damage. Alright, so we're gonna go with Scorn to damage. Choose a second squad for this. Let's just say we friends for the squad as well. Just in case. First squad gets one attack, but I highly doubt it. For this one, let's go with Brawler. Right. Challenge. This is going to be a real quick match as I'm using Zenya and Deimos. So what we'll do is I'm gonna use Krantz SPV to fill out BB gauges. Oh, it's X to the X. One. Alright, whatever, let's just use Krantz. It's gonna be a fairly quick vine. As you can see, their damage has been reduced by half with the Trident's leader skill. So let's get Finn here first. Also, I'm going to show you. I'm going to use Trident CVB to revive Eagle. I'm gonna fit this with the tattoo. So we go down. If we go still alive, she, Fenya, and Fargo, I don't remember the name, so I'm calling Fargo, we'll do a massive AoE attack. And, sometimes you can get RNG when they do that ultimate attack, so I'm gonna use Trident's UBB, UBB to survive that. Alright, so let's use Zenya's SPB. Deimos. Tridon. Now I'm almost broke it. I'll show you Tridon's UBB, SPB, and UBB animation. So let's start with the SPB first. So we mentioned we're able to HP to 50%. Somebody's in the city. Even with without grass vegetation, it's tried though. Might still survive. So strong it is. That's how strong it is. Alright. shields the other resistance grants this BBB. BBs doesn't work on the mitigation. Let's try. I'm gonna focus target on Lego now. Let's kill them all in one go. So the shield will probably. The mitigation will probably disappear in the next turn, so let's just grant to speed. Also, this is a speed. Let's focus on the Kagan now. BB boost this BB attack by 500% and attack by 40%. Oh, let's read the claims. Oh, I magically let's do it. Claim should be dead as well. Alright. Oh, we magically all three of them. This turn. Well, it's Finn. Finn survived. This should be the ultimate attack. Let's just finish her off. Let's just hope this isn't the use mitigation and it's turn. Oh, it's just mitigation. It's turn. Let's use CSBB so we can get the board of defense. Well, the board of defense actually works, but it's just a little bit of damage. It's a good thing I wrote down here, so I'm not gonna pierce their mitigation. That should be over next turn. Rising balls. Alright, that's a good fit here. Yeah. let's swing to the next one. So the next one we're going to be fighting against battle mutants. Saving. Baby. Let's. Just want to show you guys. Tridon. BB. Animation. Let's drop to BB. Earth and water, and yeah, looks really good. And then that's where we're gonna at least try to this BB. Attack will come to 50%. Now, why is trying to be the okay. Cerulean Bastille. Thank you. this drum suit you can next time. Still not good. That's what I'm doing. That's our choice. So it's our choice, yeah. Let's see Baylus final attack before he died. Only dealt about 5-10 damage. That's pretty bad, yeah. Massively decreased. Is it done? And so that was a Neptunian Tridon. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you guys next time.